Hello everyone, this is Ankit from Kailasha Foundation Funnel Learn Portal, and today we will have the next lecture of progressions chapter. So this is here in front of you. There are a few questions of geometric progressions that you will see. These questions are from CA Foundation and CPT ICI material. The second term of the series 6, 12, 24, every time you don't need a rule, you can simply see that 2 is the multiplying factor. The previous term is multiplied by 2 to obtain the next term. So 6, 2 is 12, then 24, and thereafter we get 48, and then 96, and then 192, and then 384. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 term is 384. Okay, and in the next question it is asking for 8th term of the same series T8, so 384 into 2, that is 768. But if you have to go with the rules, then I am telling you A is equal to 6, R is equal to 2. Simply you can see 12 by 6, that is 2. So 7th term will be A into R raised to the power 6, so 6 into 2 raised to the power 6, that is 6 into 64, 6 into 64, that is 384. Okay, so the same way you can do A into R raised to the power 7 to get 768. Okay, T12 of the series, so minus 128, minus, plus, minus, plus, alternate minus is there. So in odd terms there will be minus, and on even number of terms there will be plus. So first, second, third, fourth, 12th term will be positive. Okay, now 128, 64, 32, 16, and then 8, then 4, then 2, then 1. These are 8 terms. Now you go on multiplying by the same factor, that is 1 by 2, then you get 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, and 1 by 16. You can do this by rules also. A is equal to minus 128, R is equal to T2 by T1, 64 by minus 128, that is minus 1 by 2, N is equal to 12, T12 is equal to A into R raised to the power 12 minus 1, that is 11. So minus 128 into minus 1 by 2 raised to the power 11. Okay, so you will get minus power 11 times, that you know, that there will be a minus, and then again a minus, so plus 2 power 7 by 2 power 11, 1 by 2 power 4, 1 by 16 is your answer. The fourth term of the series, see, A is 0.04, and T2 by T1 you do, you will get R is equal to 0.2 by 0.04, so it will be 5. R is equal to 5, so you multiply by 5, you get this. You multiply again by 5, you get this. Then you again multiply by 5, you'll get 5. So 5 is your answer. Okay, now the last term of the series to 10 terms, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512. You can simply find this, or you can do the formula thing also. The last term of the series up to 7 terms, 1, 3, 9, 27. So you are getting 729, but you have to take care of minus sign. So first term plus, then minus, then plus, then minus, plus, minus, plus. So plus 729 will be the answer. The last term of the series to 31 terms, you have got x power 2, then x, then 1, then you get 1 by x. The fourth term is 1 by x. The fifth term is 1 by x square. So 1, 2, 3, 4 goes on and on like this. But 3 terms are spare. So 31 terms. 31 minus 3, that is 28. So the 31st term will have 1 by x raised to the power 28. Okay, 1 by x raised to the power 28. We'll do this by formula also. So a is equal to x square, r is equal to what? T2 by T1, that is 1 by x. We can also write x raised to the power minus 1. Now n is equal to 31. So Tn, that is a into r raised to the power 30, x square into x power minus 1 raised to the power 30, x square into x raised to the power minus 30. Powers will be added, so we will get x raised to the power minus 28, that is 1 by x raised to the power 28. C is our answer. The sum of the series, we can simply add these also, but we will go the formula way. So a is equal to minus 2, r is equal to t2 by t1, that is 6 by minus 2, that is minus 3, n is equal to 7, so s is equal to a, r power n minus 1 by r minus 1, okay. So we'll evaluate this, minus 2, minus 3 raised to the power, 1 minute, 7 minus 1 by minus 3 minus 1, this is minus 4 and this is minus 2, minus and minus, that will be cancelled out. So 1 by 2 will be there, and minus 3 raised to the power 7, that is minus 2187, again minus 1, so minus 2188 by 2, that is 1094. Minus 1094. The sum of the series 24 3 8 1 2 7. The sum of the series 24 3 8 1 2 7. Actually, this question is wrong. There must be misprints. Commas are I think. Okay, this is not 24 3 8 1 2 7. It is 243 81 27. 243 81 27, then 9, then 3, then 1. 243 81 27 9 3 1, and then 1 by 3, and then 1 by 9. Okay, the sum will be more than 243. No option is there, so none of these. Okay, there is misprint, commas are incorrectly placed, so you have to bear with that. There are many misprints in such materials. Now the sum of the series 1 upon root 3, then 1, then 3 upon root 3. Basically, A is this and R is root 3. Okay. A is 1 by root 3 and R is root 3. You can see that by T2 by T1. So, sum of the series to 18 terms. A is equal to 1 by root 3. R is equal to root 3. N is equal to 18. So, A r raised to the power n minus 1 upon r minus 1. This is the formula. So A, what is A? 1 upon root 3 r raised to the power n minus 1, root 3 raised to the power 18, that is 3 raised to the power 9 minus 1 upon root 3 minus 1. To rationalize, we do root 3 plus 1. Root 3 plus 1. Okay, this becomes 3 minus 1, that is 2. So 3 raised to the power 9, that is 19683 minus 1, that is 19682, basically 19682 root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 times 2. 9841 times root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 is the correct answer. The second term of GP is 24. This can't be the GP because second term is 36. This can't be the GP. 16, 24, 36, 54. In option C, the second term is 24 and fifth term, let's check. 16 multiplied by 3 by 2 will give 24. 24 multiplied by 3 by 2 will give 36. Then again 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 is our common ratio. If we multiply 54 further by 3 by 2, then we get 81. So yes, this is our series. But what is the appropriate method to solve this? A is equal to 16. R is equal to 3 by 2. No, not this way. We have to go from questions, na? From question, not from options. So, second term, AR is equal to 24. Fifth term, AR to the power 4 is 81. So, when we divide, we get R cube is equal to 81 by 24. That is 27 by 8. R is equal to 3 by 2. R is equal to 3 by 2. R is equal to 3 by 2. And when I put R here, so I get A is equal to 16. This is our correct answer. Option C. The sum of three numbers of a GP. This is not a GP. You can clearly see that. Then 3 is multiplied by 9 and we are getting 27. Multiplying 27 by 9 will never give us 9. So this is not a GP. This also is not a GP. This is a GP. The sum of three numbers of a GP is 39. Yes. And their product is 729. Yes again. So C is our correct answer. B is wrong. A is wrong. C is our correct answer. In a GP, product of first three terms is 27 by 8. Yes. Three unknowns in GP. How do we assume that? Three unknowns in GP. We must take A by R, A and AR. So, three unknowns in GP, the product of first three terms is 27 by 8. A by R, A and AR. When we multiply these three, we get A cube. A cube is 27 by 8. So, A is 3 by 2. Middle term is 3 by 2. Middle term is 3 by 2. Okay. If you save 1 paise today, to the next date 1, 2, 4, 8 and so on, so it is a GP. Savings in 2 weeks, that means 14 days. So it is asking for sum, but keep in mind we have to take the sum of paisa, not rupees, and then in the end we will convert it in rupees. Okay, so A is equal to 1, R is equal to 2, N is equal to 14, S is equal to A R raised to the power N minus 1 upon R minus 1. You can also memorize that. The sum of this sequence is always 2 raised to the power N minus 1. You will see that 2 minus 1 is 1. This is 1 also. So basically it is 2 raised to the power 14 minus 1. So 2048, 489, 4096 and then 8192 and then 16384 minus 1 that is 16383. So 163.83 paisa, this is 163.83. Now we'll see 15 and 16. Okay. Now, 4, okay. 4 plus 44 plus 444 and so on. There must be many ways to solve this problems, but I will tell you two ways. One the long method and one the trick. Okay. If you see it carefully, it is neither a GP nor an AP. So obviously you need a new way to evaluate the sum. Whenever we come across such problems, we have to do one thing. So we have to take 4 by 9 common. If the series is 5, 5, 5, then we will take 5 by 9 common, and obviously with our common sense. So we are taking 4 by 9. So we are getting here 9, 99, 999, and so on. Okay. This will be, this can again be written as 9 can be written as 10 minus 1. This is 100 minus 1. This is 1000 minus 1. And so on. Now this is something, because 10, 100, 1000, these all constitute a GP. And every time there is a minus 1, so it is n times, collectively it is minus n. And the remaining is 10 power 1, 10 power 2, 10 power 3 up to 10 power n. This is a GP. This part is a GP. Okay. Now this can be solved. 4 by 9 A into R raised to the power n minus 1 by R minus 1, that is 10 minus 1. So 9 again. This is our answer. But what we can do, we can just take the sum of two terms, that is 48. Now we can put, because we are taking the sum of two numbers, so we can put 2 in the options in the place of n. In the place of n, we'll put 2 in the options, and whichever option gives us 48 will be the correct answer. Okay, this is B, A, B, C, D. So when we put n is equal to 2 in this, we are getting 48. See, 4 by 9 times 10 by 9, 10 raised to the power n minus 1, that is 100 minus 1, that is 99, minus n, that is 2. Okay, 110 minus 2, 108, 4 by 9 into 108, 12 4 ja 48. Okay, the same way you can go in case of question number 16. This time you will take 1 by 9 common, and this time instead of 10 minus 1, 100 minus 1, 1000 minus 1, you will get 1 minus 0.1, 1 minus 0.01, and so on. So the situation will change like this only, and there will not be bigger changes. So B will be the correct answer in this question. You can try this. If you are stuck again, you can ask me the question over WhatsApp, 8294600829. I'll help you out. Okay, remember, this number is not for call, this number is only for WhatsApp. You can 8294600829 WhatsApp us, and you can ask your doubts. The sum of first 20 terms of a GP is 240 times the sum of its first 10 terms. Sorry, sum of first 20 terms. Okay, so S20 is equal to 10 times, sorry, 244 times S10. S20 is equal to 244 into S10. We can do it here. A into R raised to the power 20 minus 1 by R minus 1, that is S20 is equal to 244 times A into R raised to the power 10 minus 1 by R minus 1. This will be cancelled out. A will be cancelled out. R raised to the power 10, say that is x, so this is x square minus 1 is equal to 244 times x minus 1. When we cancel these out, we get x plus 1 is equal to 244. So x is equal to 243. Okay, so R raised to the power 10 is equal to 243. R will be equal to R raised to the power 10 is 243 to the, that is 3 raised to the power 5. So r square is equal to 3. R will be equal to plus minus root 3. Okay. R will be equal to plus minus root 3. So A is our correct answer. Sum of the series, this is 364. So the last term must be less than 364. 1, 3, 9, 27, 81, and 243. The six terms will give us the sum 364. Okay. How did I do that? Let me tell you again. Sum is 364, so all the terms are less than 364. The last term less than 364 is 243. And if we are afraid, we can check it by adding 243, 81, 27, 9, 3, and 1. We get 364. So this is our correct answer, 6 terms. Okay. Now 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, and 24. Sum of the series, this I already told you a few questions ago, 2 raised to the power 9 minus 1. The product of 3 numbers is GP. 3 numbers in GP, not GP, not GP. This one is GP. Sum of squares is 819. We can check that out. 3 raised to the power 2 is 9, and then plus 81, and then plus 729. We are getting 819. Okay, so option C is correct. Question number 22, sum of infinite GP. Sum of infinite GP is A by 1 minus R. That is 1 by 1 plus 1 by 3 by 4, 0.75. The sum of infinite GP, 14 minus 2 plus 2 is A by 1 minus R. A is equal to 14. R is equal to minus 1 by 7. Okay. A by 1 minus R, 14 by 1 plus 1 by 7, that is 8 by 7. 14 sevens are 98 upon 8. 98 upon 8. That is 49 by 4. So 12, 1 by 4. The number of terms to be taken, so that this will be 8191, 2 raised to the power n minus 1 is equal to 8191. Okay. So n will be equal to 13, I think. 2 raised to the power n is 8192, so 2 raised to the power 10 is 1024, then 2048, then 4096, then 8198. Okay, 13 is the correct answer. 4 geometric means between 4 and 972. At first, the 4 geometric means must themselves be in GP. This is not in GP, this is not in GP, this is not in GP. So none of these. And also, if any of these were in GP, then we had to place those 4 numbers between 4 and 972, and this entire sequence must be in GP. Okay, the correct answer will be 12, 36, 108, and 324. We can figure that out by just looking at the options, because all options are revolving around these 4 numbers. Okay, but the appropriate method to find these numbers is, that is what I am telling you, question number 24, 4 and 972. N geometric means between A and B, so N is equal to 4, A is equal to 4, B is equal to 972. We have to find R only. 4 and 972 are here. We have to place 4 numbers between, and for that we have to find R. We already have our first term. R is equal to B by A raised to the power 1 by n plus 1. So 972 by 240, sorry, 97, B by A. B is 972, A is 4. 1 by 4 plus 1, that is 5. This is 243 is 3 raised to the power 5, 2 into 1 by 5, that is 3, R is 3, so 4 3s are 12, 12 3s are 36, then 108, and then 3, 2, 4. So at this speed, we have solved the entire exercise of 24 questions in approx 24 minutes, and I have explained these questions also. In a few questions, I have used two methods to describe. I haven't just solved the questions my way. I have told you how to do these. I have described. So I took 24 or 25 minutes, whatever you say. If you got these methods right, then you will also take this time, or in fact less time than 24 or 25 minutes to solve these questions. Okay, so one or two lectures are more about to come of this progressions chapter, and on demand we can produce as many lectures as there are needed. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Happy learning. Bye-bye. Thank you so much.